Hello everyone, my name is Tirup Parmar. I'm a professor. This is something brief about me, as you can see. Now, in this particular lecture, I'll be discussing about ransomware, that is one of the most dangerous thing anyone, any technical or non-technical person, whosoever knows something about computers, they basically scare of something that is called as ransomware. Now, this particular topic in detail I'm going to discuss here. I'll also show you how we can tackle such situations. And if you have any doubt or query, feel free to ping me on this particular email address. So let's start discussing about ransomware. First, we'll discuss what we mean by a ransomware. As you can see, I've listed out few points here, but a ransomware, which is also known as rugware or scareware, basically what this particular software or this particular a small program, what it does is it restricts access to your computer system and demands that a ransom is paid. That is, some money should be paid in return if you want to unlock your system or if you want to unlock your files. That's what it does. So let's discuss it from this particular example. So as you can see how ransomware works, basically it starts with an unsolicited email. So it basically tricks you down to click on any particular email, or it basically gives you some of the links. You just need to click on those links, and as soon as you click on those URLs, some macros or basically some executable files gets executed or gets affected on your system. So as you can see, and ransomware starts with an unsolicited email typically designed to trick the victim into clicking on attach or visiting web page. So they just force you or they just trick you to click on any particular URL. Now the ransomware leverages flaws in a computer operating system to force it to run ransomware code. So as soon as you click on those particular URLs, in background there are some programs which starts executing itself without the permission of operating system, or they basically find some loopholes or some backdoors which is present in your operating system. Now once this code starts executing, they basically what this basically ransomware does is they basically encrypts most important files present on your system. And now what we mean by encryption? Encryption means they basically lock your files or they basically convert your readable files into non-readable formats. So once this particular files are now converted or encrypted, if you want to read or get the access of this file, you need a key to decrypt those files or to make it again in a normal format, then only you will be able to access it. And if you want that key or if you want to decrypt your files, you need to pay some money or a ransom to this hackers. That's what we mean by this particular attack. So as you can see, important files on system and demands a ransom payment using digital currency, that is Bitcoin. As we know, Bitcoin is a cryptocurrency. It does not basically handled by any particular bank. So if I make any transaction using a Bitcoin, one cannot trace our transaction because it is not handled by any single server which belongs to any XYZ bank. So any particular person who basically uses this particular cryptocurrency or also called as Bitcoins for a transaction or for as a payment method, one cannot easily trace where money is going. So WannaCry is a ransomware uses a Windows flow to replicate itself and spread around a computer network. So it works exactly same like our worms work. They also affects or they also attacks on a computer network the same way this is also doing itself. Or Trojan horse also makes or replicates itself, and it basically spreads or attached with each and every file which is present on your system. The same thing is done with this particular WannaCry ransomware as well. Now these are few tools. Now before discussing these tools, let me just tell you some of the basic points which we also need to discuss about this ransomware. So let's discuss where this ransomware comes from. It is created by a scammer who are highly knowledgeable in computer programming. It can enter your PC through an email attached or through your browser if you happen to visit a web page or a website that is infected with this type of malware. It can also access your PC via your network. Now, how to recognize? It's obvious when your device has been infected with ransomware, since you most likely won't be able to access your computer. So that's what we can easily trace down, that some attack or some ransomware is affected our system. Now, how to remove this ransomware? Make use of antivirus softwares. They are the most likely one who can help you out with this particular situation. So there are many antivirus software ransomware removal tools which should scan for and wipe out any ransomware attack found on your computer. So I have listed down few of the free ransomware removal tools which is available. As you can see, these are the few tools which can help you out with, or with using this particular tools you can tackle down the situation. So I hope one can easily tackle this situation. Now, the most important part, don't pay any ransom to this particular attacker. Remember, you can use such situation, you can take the help of any technical person to tackle down this situation. So here are, these are the all things which you should do. Now, as you can see, WannaCry, how to prevent ransom attack. Make sure all software on your computer is up to date, including your operating system, browser, and any toolbar plugin which we are using on our browser. Ensure that your antivirus software and firewall protection is also up to date. Now, how to protect yourself with anti-ransomware? There is no better way to recognize, remove, and prevent ransomware than to use an antivirus and anti-ransomware. Remember, now WannaCry has infected, as you can see, has infected Telefonic and NHS hospitals in spreading aggressively with over 50,000 attacks so far. So as you can see, the main attack or main cities which is basically targeted by this particular attacker is Russian. Then there are few other cities like massive perk in WannaCry ransom attacks with more than 57,000 detection. Ransomware is mainly being targeted to Russia, Ukraine, Taiwan, but the ransomware has successfully infected major institutions like hospital across England and Spanish telecommunication company, that is Telefonica. Now, few things, as you can see, we saw the first version of WannaCry, the same thing which I discussed, the first version of WannaCry in February, and now the ransomware is available in 28 different languages, from languages like Bulgarian to Vietnamese. Again, notice an increase in activity of this strain, which quickly escalated into a massive spreading beginning at 10 a.m. on Friday. The ransomware changes the affected file extension. Now remember, it basically changes the file extension into .vncry. So an infected file will look something like this. If our original file named like this, that is original name of file xyz.jpg, and after that you will find this type of an extension to each and every file. Now this file needs an encrypted file also marked by WannaCry string at the beginning of the file. So as you can see, the ransomware drops the following ransom notes in a text file as well. Here is that particular file. So you will find this type of a notepad where there are some question, what's wrong with your file, what is happening, and few other details. Furthermore, the ransomware being demanded, as you can see, it basically demands $300 worth of Bitcoin. So as I said, what we mean by Bitcoin, it is a cryptocurrency. One cannot find out or one cannot trace the transaction where we are sending or receiving money. So that's what it works like. You'll find this type of a window if you're affected with this particular type of an attack. Here is address given and how to buy a Bitcoin. They have also provided a link, how to buy Bitcoin and few other details. Like if you want pay money in this particular time period, which is left out here, then their ransom will be doubled, and after 7 days they are going to delete all your files. Now, in addition, the victim's wallpaper is also changed to following image. As you can see here, on your wallpaper, it will display such type of an image. Now, next part is, this attack once again proved that ransomware is a powerful weapon that can be used against any consumer business alike. Ransomware becomes particularly nasty when it infects institution. Now, it is the most dangerous part when it can affect or infect the institutions like hospitals, where it can put people's life in danger. Now, infection vector WannaCry is most likely spreading on so many computers by using an exploit, the equation group. Remember, they are using one exploit, the equation group, which is a group that is widely suspected of being tied to the NSA, National Security Agencies of US, used for its dirty business. And again, a hacker group called Shadow Broker has stolen Equation Group's hacking tool and has publicly released them. As affirmed by security researcher Kefin, the exploit known as Eternal Blue, or it is also known as MS-17010, was probably used by the cyber criminal behind WannaCry. And one more thing, how it affects the Windows system using this particular vulnerability, that is its exploits, or it's probably used by cyber criminal behind WannaCry and Windows Server Message Block, a network file sharing protocol. That is one of the main we can say a loophole or a drawback or one of the backdoor which they have used to enter or basically to affect most of Windows based operating system computers. Now, cyber criminal behind WannaCry is Windows usually fully updated with their system with the latest available patches. Indian origin. Now remember, Indian origin techie links ransomware attack in North Korea. This is something in a news right now. And as you can see, this researcher from a Google, that is Neil Mehta, an Indian origin security researcher at Google, has found evidence that North Korean hacker may be responsible for cyber attack that affected 150 countries. Now, Neil Mehta coded has been termed as most significant clue to date by Russian security firms as well. Now, researchers have said that some of the code used in Friday's ransomware known as WannaCry software was nearly identical to used by Lazarus Group, a North Korean-based hacker who used a similar version of devastating hack for Sony Pictures Entertainment in the year 2014, and last year hack of Bangladesh Central Bank as well. Now, security experts are also cautiously linking the Lazarus groups to this latest attack after the discovery by Mehta. Mehta has found similarity between code found within WannaCry and other tools believed to have created by Lazarus Group in past BBC report as well. So as you can see, Neil Mehta, a researcher at Google, also tweeted this particular part. So where he's showing that there are many, many similarities between attack which was happened on Bangladesh Central Bank, which was also happened on many other parts as well. By whom? By North Korean based hackers. Now, one more thing, the security experts Professor Alan Gooden said that timestamp within the original WannaCry code was set up to UTC+9, that is China's time zone, and text demanding the ransom uses what reads like machine translated English, but a Chinese segment apparently written by a native speaker, Neil Mehta discovered, is the most significant clue to date regarding origin of WannaCry. It is important that other researchers around the world investigate these similarities and attempt to discover more fact about the origin of WannaCry. North Korea has never admitted any involvement in Sony Pictures hack, and while security researchers and US government have confidence in the theory, neither can rule out the possibility of false flag. Now, sorry, one more thing which I would like to highlight here, that skilled hacker may have simply made it look like it had origin in North Korea by using similar techniques. So just to mislead, they basically used same techniques or same code which North Korea attempted on Sony Pictures as well as Bangladesh Central Bank. Now, in case of WannaCry, it is possible that attacker simply copied code from earlier attack by Lazarus Group. And it's a strongest theory yet to origin of WannaCry, but there are also details that arguable point away from it being the work of North Korea. Now, two important things before we discuss about this. As you can see, where are the attacks happen on which countries? So, first, China was among the country worst hitted. Remember, China was also hitted, and not accidentally, the hacker made sure there was a version of ransom note written in Chinese. It seems unlikely North Korea would want to antagonistically its strongest ally, Russia, was badly affected. And second is, North Korean cyber attack have typically been far more targeted, often with a political goal in mind. In case of Sony Pictures, hackers sought to prevent the release of The Interview, a film that mocked North Korean leader Kim Jong-un. And next thing, WannaCry, in contrast, was widely indiscriminate. It would infect anything and everything it could. And finally, if the plan was simply to make money, it's been pretty unsuccessful on that front too. Only around $60,000 has been paid in ransom, according to analysis of Bitcoin account being used by the criminals. With more than 2 lakh machines infected, it's a terrible return. Remember, it's a terrible return if we say this particular thing. The global reach is unprecedented. The latest count is over 2 lakh victims in at least 150 countries. And those victims, many of those will be businesses, including large corporations. The most disruptive attack were reported in UK, where hospitals and clinics were forced to turn away patients after losing access to computers. These are the countries which are badly affected, as you can see, in many of the ransomware attacks. Now, in case of WannaCry, it's possibly that hackers simply copied code from earlier attack by Lazarus Group. The WannaCry ransom hacker made some real immature mistakes. Now, what are those mistakes? We'll just discuss this. WannaCry attack has quickly become the worst digital disaster to strike the internet in years. Now, one more thing. Crippling transportation and hospital globally. They have crippled transportation and hospitals, but it increasingly appears that this is not the work of hackers mastermind. Instead, cybersecurity investigators see in the recent meltdown a sloppy cyber criminal scheme, one that reveals immature mistakes at practically every turn. As the unprecedented ransomware attacks known as WannaCry unfolds, the cybersecurity community has marveled an inexplicable error the malware's author have made. Despite the giant footprint of attack, which leveraged a leaked NSA-created Windows hacking tricks to infect more than 2 lakh systems across 150 countries, malware analysts say poor choice on the part of WannaCry's creator have limited both its scope and profit. Those errors include building in web-based kill switch. Remember, one of the most important part, kill switch. Using this particular trick or kill switch only, many government based intelligent agency were able to halt this particular attack, that is ransomware. Now, what we mean by this kill switch? As he worked to reverse engineering samples of WannaCry, Malware Tech, this is the company who basically identified this kill switch, discovered that ransomware's programmer had built it to check whether a certain URL lead to live web page. Curious why the ransomware would look for that domain. Malware Tech registered it themselves. Remember, they have registered one URL which was directing all the victims to that particular domain. Now, malware tag registered this particular domain on themselves, as it turns out that just by spending $10 investment was enough to shut down the whole thing. It turned out that as long as the domain was unregistered and inactive, the query had no effect on ransomware spread. But once the ransomware checked the URL and found it active, they have shut down the system. Now, competing theories exist as to why WannaCry's perpetrator built it this way. One possibility might be that the functionality was put in place as an intentional kill switch in case the creator even wanted to rein the monster they have created. Now, they have created this kill switch only if the situation goes out of hand. Just to stop that spread, they have created this kill switch. But apparently, malware tech find out about this particular kill switch. Based on behavior implemented in the code, the kill switch was most likely intentional. Hackers could have included the feature to shield the ransomware from analysis. That sort of examination often take place in controlled environment, and that is what we call as sandbox. Researchers construct some of this environment to trick malware into thinking it's querying outside server, even though it's really talking to a bunch of dummy sandbox IP addresses. As a result, any address the malware tries to reach gets a response, even if the actual domain is unregistered. Since the domain malware tech required as supposed to be dormant but went live, WannaCry may have assumed it was in the middle of forensic analysis and they've shut it down. Building anti-analysis defense into malware is common, but WannaCry hackers appear to have botched the implementation by relying on a static discoverable address. Whoever find it, in this case, malware tech could just register the domain and trigger WannaCry shutdown defense. Now, what we mean by this temporary fix, or which is called as sinkhole. Now, the kill switch doesn't help devices WannaCry has already infected and locked down. So this temporary fix is to stop further attacks, but not to reverse attack which has already happened. So already infected and locked down, but by registering the domain and then directing the traffic to it into a server environment meant to capture and hold malicious traffic, known as sinkhole. Remember, they have diverted a traffic that is called as sinkhole. They are sinking the whole attack. The discovery doesn't amount to a permanent fix. This is not a permanent fix. This is just a temporary fix. So it might possible in future, they might come up with a newer version of the same. So all it would take to get around, it would be a new strain of WannaCry whose code excluded the kill switch or relies on a more sophisticated URL generated instead of a static address. And more fundamental problem of vulnerable devices, particularly Windows XP devices. They are remains the most vulnerable. Remember, Windows XP devices remains till now, they are the most vulnerable devices or operating systems. Now, when we talk about something else here, as those errors included building in web-based kill switch that cut short its spread, unsavvy handling of Bitcoin payments. Now, remember, they are demanding ransom in form of Bitcoins, but they are not also in a form of much savvy manner or in a much practical or a mature manner. The way they are demanding Bitcoin, they are also very, very immature thing. So, unsavvy handling of Bitcoin payment that makes it far easier to track the hackers group profit, and even a shoddy ransom function in the malware itself. There are some function which is already present in this malware. So one can easily check out what are the ways they are basically going to find out how one can making payments to them and how they are going to decrypt their files. So that's what we are going to discuss here. An attack of this magnitude involves so many mistakes, raising plenty of Questions: if actual cyber criminal professional improved on the groups of methods, the result could be even graver. So these are not a professional one. As per the research till now, if they are a professional one, then this particular attack might be more gravest or more dangerous. So as you can see, they have just earned this much money only by infecting millions and millions of computers, and that is also at professional level, industry level. So as you can see, mistakes which are made at last count, the group behind WannaCry has earned just $55,000 from its internet shaking attack, a small function of multi-million dollar profit of more professional steal the ransomware scheme. From a ransom perspective, it's a catastrophic failure. It's a failure on their side. Whether they have not made it in a proper manner, or there are some mistakes or failures from their side. So as you can see, there is a researcher which is with the name Matthew Hackey, a researcher at London-based college. Now, what they are saying and why and how they basically reach to some conclusions. So high damages, very high publicity, very high enforcement visibility, and it has probably the lowest profit margin ever seen from any moderate or even small ransom campaign. Now, as you can see, the Matthew Hackey from a research department of London-based security firm, he's saying that WannaCry's code and found that malware doesn't automatically verify that a particular victim has paid the demand of $300 worth Bitcoin ransom by assigning them a unique Bitcoin address. They should have done this by assigning a unique Bitcoin address. They should find out whether a demanded money is being paid by that victim or not. Instead, it provides only one of four hard-coded Bitcoin address, meaning incoming payments doesn't have identifying detail that could help automate the decryption process. Instead, the criminal themselves have had to figure out which computer to decrypt as ransom comes in. An unintended arrangement gives the hundreds of thousands of infected devices. It's really a manual process at the other end, and someone has to acknowledge and send a key. Remember, they are not doing on some automatic basis. As you can see here, its setup will inevitably lead to criminal failing to decrypt computers even after payment. Why? Because they will not be able to detect whether some person or a victim who actually paid money to them or not, because they have not provided some automatic method just against the payment decrypt their files. No, they are doing it manually, and you can just imagine they have infected millions and millions of computers, and in this situation, manually decrypting each and every computer's data or each and helping each and every victim after paying ransom, it's way too difficult. Already been monitored, one victim who paid more than who already paid money to them, and after more than 12 hours ago, and he's yet to receive decryption key through which he can decrypt his files. They are not really prepared to deal with outbreak of this scale. Using only four hard-coded Bitcoin addresses in the malware not only introduces the payments problem, but also makes it far easier for the security community and law enforcement to track any attempt to crash or to cash out WannaCry profit. Just to find out how many payments they are receiving, it's very easy for all the law enforcement agencies and all the intelligence agency as well. All Bitcoin transactions are visible on Bitcoin's public accounting ledger known as blockchain. Remember, there is a ledger like banks used to maintain their transaction the same way over internet. On a global way, all the Bitcoin holders, they can check out the transaction using a ledger or an entry like we use Microsoft tools to make a ledger. The same way, there are also ledgers or a entry book which is present for bitcoins as well. So from there, one can easily find out how many money is being transferred on any particular one bitcoin ID. That's what it means. So it looks impressive as hell because you think they must be genuine coders in order to integrate the NSA exploit into a virus. So they are not that big developer or that big coder. Why? Because they only know how to find out or how to fetch the software which is developed by National Security Agency, US based NSA. But now they are not be capable enough to handle the same thing in a proper efficient manner, and that basically leads to their profit loss. They have hard-coded Bitcoin address rather than one Bitcoin address per victim shows their limited thinking. Now, Cisco researchers, they also found out that check payment button in a ransomware. Remember, Cisco researchers also find out this particular check payment button in ransomware doesn't actually even check if any Bitcoin have been sent or not. It randomly provides one of the four answers. So it not actually checking whether a ransom is paid by that victim or not. No, they have hard coded four answers. Now, three fake error messages or a fake decryption message. That's it. This are the four messages which they are providing. If the hacker are decrypting anyone's file, it's through a manual process of communication with victim via a malware's contact button. So they have also provided contact button there. Now, one more thing, by arbitrarily sending decryption key to a few users to give victims the illusion that paying the ransom does free their files. And unlike more functional and automated ransom attack, that janky process provides almost no incentive for anyone to actually pay up. It breaks the entire trust model that makes ransomware work. To be fair, WannaCry has spread with a speed and scale that ransomware has never achieved before. Its use of recently leaked NSA Windows vulnerability called Eternal Blue. They have used something, Windows vulnerability called Eternal Blue. Remember, this is one of the main tasks or one of the main reason behind the success of this WannaCry ransomware. Now, but even judging WannaCry solely by its ability to spread its creator made huge blunders. They inexplicably built a kill switch, that is the one of the biggest mistakes from their side, into their code designed to reach out to a unique web address and disable its encryption payload if it makes a successful connection. The feature might be a stealth measure designed to avoid detection if the code is running on a virtual test machine, but it also allowed a pseudonymous researchers who goes by the name MalwareTech to simply register that domain. And that is what happened in this case as well. MalwareTech just registered a domain which they were using, and their attack is just stopped at one time only, just with the spending of $10. They just registered one domain which is worth of $10, and this particular $10 investment or registering a domain on their name just stopped catastrophic attack. Now remember one more point. Over the weekend, a new version of WannaCry was also appeared. Now, as you can see, ransomware known as Angular estimated 60 million a year before getting shut down in 2015. This is one example of another ransomware which was not so popular, but they have earned this much money. And you can just imagine the most popular ransomware in today's time whose earning is so less. So you can just see how they fail on their side. Over the weekend, a new version of WannaCry appeared with a different kill switch address. Now this different kill switch address was also detected by Dubai based security researchers registered that second domain immediately on their name, cutting short the spread of that adapt version of the malware too. Now, Dubai-based security researchers can't imagine why the hacker haven't yet coded their malware to reach out to a randomly generated URL rather than a static one built into a ransomware's code. don't see any obvious explanation for why there's still a kill switch. Why there is still a kill switch, same mistake twice, which is one of the biggest mistake from their side. Now, as you can see, the same mistake twice, especially one that effectively shuts WannaCry down, makes little sense. It seems like a logic bomb. That's it, nothing more than that. So as you can see, WannaCry, we caused how much damage? But the little profit that some security researchers have begin to suspect that it may not be a money-making scheme at all. Instead, they speculate it might be someone trying to embrace NSA, National Security Agency of US, by just by cricking or just by trying to hack their tools. That's what it looks like. And a more professional operations could improve on WannaCry's technique to inflict far worse damages as well. So this is one of the most important drawback, as you can see, all of which has vastly limited WannaCry's profit, even as a ransomware has shut down life-saving equipment in hospital and paralyzed trains, ATMs and subway systems as well. Earlier and much publicized ransomware campaign known as Angular took in an estimated 60 million. As I said, it took like 60 million a year before getting shut it down. And if we talk about WannaCry, whose profit is so less, then it might be a major drawback, or it might be a failure from their side, or it might be attack which is not from professional ones. This is conclusion on which we can reach out after discussing so many things. I hope this particular points are clear to you. I have also provided those softwares or those anti-ransomware tools which we can use to handle with our systems. I hope everything is clear to each and every one of you. If you have any doubt or query, feel free to ping me on my email address which I have provided in starting of the lecture, and at the same time you can also write it down in a comment section. See you in the next lecture, where I'll be discussing about more of such tools, because as we know, once we are infected with some such type of attack, it might possible some other type of attack might possible. So we should have clear understanding about what we mean by malware, spyware, adware, what we mean by computer virus, Trojan horse, rootkit virus, phishing, keylogger, what we actually mean by hacker, how they basically infect our system, what we mean by social engineering, what we mean by spams, what is scam over internet, browser hijacker, what we mean by computer worm, what do you mean by identity theft, what is cybercrime, what do you mean by cracking, what is distributed DOS, botnet, cyberbullying, sniffer, and many different things. So stay tuned, I'll be discussing all other detail in all other these things in detail in my next lecture. Thank you.